This is a neural network. Its job is to train itself and learn how to drive a car on a randomly generated path, avoiding collisions with the road borders and trying to go as fast as possible. But how can you do it? Very quickly, a neural network is a collection of nodes, called neurons, linked together by connections with a weight between minus 1 and 1. These neurons are organized in layers, where the first is called the input layer and the last the output layer, and every one of them can have a value between 0 and 1. 8 of the 9 input neurons represent the sensors of the car, which detect the distance from the road borders in a specific direction. They have a value 1 if the wall is touching the car, decreasing to 0 if it goes out of the sensor range. The 9th instead is the velocity of the car itself, ranging from 0 to its maximum speed. These nodes can be connected to neurons in the hidden layers or in the output layer, and the information carried across the connection is the product of the node value by the connection weight. The receiving neurons combine all the input values into an output using a specific function, which then is sent forward in the network. At the end of the chain reaction, the 4 output nodes have 4 different values that can trigger an action if they go over a certain threshold, such as 0.5. These actions tell the car to accelerate, brake, turn left or right. To create a network capable of driving the car, we need to create the right number of nodes in the hidden layers and assign to the connections the proper weights. And here we are to the neat part, because to do that I use the neat module in Python. Dumb joke, right? Anyway, neat stands for neural evolution of augmented topologies, and it works like this. At the starting line, many simple neural networks are created, each of them driving its own car. These networks are randomly generated, so they have absolutely no idea of what they're doing. Yeah, the results speak for themselves, they are trash. Since we already spoke about the neurons, here we are to the evolution part, to which car is given a score, called fitness. If they start wandering and crash into wall at supersonic speed, they are going to have what they deserve, but if they can stay on track longer than their rivals, their fitness will be higher. At the end of the run, when all the cars are dead, the best networks are selected and are allowed to generate children, which will be the pilots of the cars in the next run. These cars will race again, and they will perform better than before. I mean, not much better, but better nonetheless. So let's make some more babies and run it again. Over and over and over. And here is where we get to the augmented topologies bit. A child will have some of the characteristics of the parent, but also new traits, which can be a different value in a connection here, a new connection there, or a new neuron in the hidden layers. Going down the generations, as the new networks get more complicated, their structure, so their topology, is going to get bigger and bigger to achieve the best fitness possible. As you can probably, maybe, imagine, this is going to take a long time. If you don't want to wait hours of training just to see some cars move on a screen without crashing, which, by the way, is the concept of any racing video game ever, you can adjust the settings, giving them a lower maximum speed and a tighter turning radius. They will learn very soon to keep the foot on the gas and never brake, just turning left or right. Again, like any noob on any racing video game ever. Right. If instead you have nothing better to do, you can make the road tighter or introduce new features like bicycles, intersections, traffic lights, and congratulations nerd, you just got a job at Tesla. One thing to note is that these networks are just a bunch of numbers, so they have no morals and they love cheating. Wait, what? Oh, you dumb